of Almighty Allah, we are going to read and transmit some of traditions, some spiritual transmissions which have been related by Imam Ibn Qudamah in his book Kitab al-Riqqati wal-Buka. This is the book at the moment which I am holding, and in the last session I am giving a lesson from Kitab al-Riqqati wal-Buka. This great book on spirituality and on renunciation and on weariness has been written by the great Imam Muwaffaq al-Din Abdullah bin Ahmad bin Qudama al-Maqdisi al-Hanbali, and he has been the student, one of the most famous students of Sayyidina al-Ghawth al-Azam Shaykh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. He has been his student, Imam Ibn Qudama al-Maqdisi al-Hanbali, and he wore khirqah of tasawwuf from Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani himself. And he is known to be, I would say he is wrongly known to be, one of the prominent Salafi scholars and muhaddiseen. Some people consider him in the list of Salafi scholars by mistake. But the position, his position is that he was a murid, a disciple, and he received the khirqah of tasawwuf, of suluk, from Sayyidina Ghawth al-Azam Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani. He says, Al-Basani khirqatan. This is one aspect of his career, academic career. Other aspect, very interesting, is that he is Grand Shaykh of Allama Ibn Taymiyyah. He is Great Grand Shaykh of Allama, Great Grand Shaykh of Allama Ibn Taymiyyah. This is other aspect of his personality. And he is the one who is author of Ar-Rawdah fi Usul al-Fiqh and Al-Umdah and Al-Kafi fi al-Fiqh al-Hanbaliyyah and Lum'atul Itiqad and Al-Mughni Sharh Mukhtasar Al-Khiraqi and Al-Mizan fi Usul al-Fiqh. He is known to be the great Imam of Al-Fiqh al-Hanbaliyyah. Great Imam of Fiqh al-Hanbaliyyah. And he was given the title of Shaykh al-Islam. He was born in 541 Hijra. His book Kitab al-Riqqah wal-Buka, I'm quoting from this book, he relates through Muhammad bin Yazid bin Khunais and from him Sayyid bin Sulaiman al-Wasiti relates on his authority. First of all, Sa'id bin Sulaiman, and he relates all traditions with complete continuous asanid, chains of authority. Every single tradition he quotes is with continuous authority, chain of authority. Bil asanid al-muttasila ala tariq al-muhaddisin. And Imam Sa'id bin Sulaiman al-Wasti relates from Muhammad bin Yazid bin Khunais. And he relates from Abdul Aziz bin Abi Rawad. And Abdul Aziz bin Abi Rawad, he was one of the great Atba'ut Tabi'een, who died in 159. And Imam Abdullah bin Mubarak said that whenever he used to speak and deliver the lecture, you would see the tears on his face and cheeks. He was amongst the great worshippers, renouncers. This Abdul Aziz bin Abi Rawad, his actual name is Abdul Aziz bin Maymoon bin Abi Rawad bin Badr al-Makki. And he was a Siqa Imam of Hadith. This is stated by Imam Yahya bin Sa'id al-Qattan. And same is declared by Imam Abdullah bin Mubarak about him. So this is a great, reliable and Siqa authority on Hadith. Imam Ibn Qudama has related on his authority, and he says, when this Quranic verse, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara, verse number 6 of Surah At-Tahrim, was revealed, that believers, you should save yourself and your family and children from the hellfire. You should work hard to save yourself and your family from hellfire. When this verse of Holy Quran was revealed, he says, Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in the company of the companions. They were sitting in the company of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam qara'aha Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ala ashabihi. He recited this verse on his companions. This lesson of today will serve two things. One, of course, to open the fountain of spirituality and spiritual relationship to Almighty Allah through this lesson of suluk. Secondly, to establish that all spiritual states and conditions which the tasawwuf and tariqah and haqiqah is based on, they were not introduced, or they were not innovated, or they were not concocted, and they were not fabricated, and they were not infiltrated by the scholars or the Sufiya or the saints or saintly people afterwards, and they were introduced externally in Islam. Thinking in this way would be totally wrong, baseless, and against any kind of evidence. All spiritual stages which we read and know about the awliya and salihin, and all spiritual states of the hearts, spiritual states of the spirits, and the states, spiritual states of the inner selves, and spiritual states of the secrets and secrets of secrets, whatever we read in their lives, was in fact in existence in the days of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself. And we can easily find these states and conditions in the lives of the companions. So these are the roots and origins where tasawwuf, spirituality, suluk and tariqah and haqiqah has emerged from. So it is not an innovation. It is not a new addition to Islam in the later centuries. No, these are the states and conditions which were practiced and which were achieved and attained by the companions in the days of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his glorious presence. This is the second thing. That's why I am quoting this lesson of spirituality from a book written by a great Imam of Hadith and Fiqh, known as a Salafi Imam, and he is a great Imam of Al-Fiqh Al-Hanbaliyya, and nobody denies his authority, Ibn Qudama, as he is a great Grand Sheikh of Allama Ibn Taymiyyah, and great Grand Sheikh of Allama Ibn Al-Qayyim, and great Grand Sheikh of Allama Hafiz Ibn Kathir. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited this verse to his companions and he says, فَخَرَّ أَحَدٌ مِّن صَحَابِهِ مَغْشِيًّا. There was a one young sahabi sitting in the company of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He fell down and he became unconscious. He had a wajd. He became unconscious. All of a sudden he fell down on the floor. Just on the sama, in hearing of this Quranic verse, Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam never said, what are you doing? What has happened to you? What is this kind of activity? No. He realized that this is a state of spirituality. So Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam got up. فَوَضَعَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَدَهُ عَلَى فُوَادِهِ. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam placed his holy hands on his heart. فَإِذَا هُوَ يَتَحَرَّكُ. And he started trembling like a fish when Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam put his hand on his heart. And Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, يَا فَتَى قُلْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ فَقَالَهَا فَبَشَّرَهُ بِالْجَنَّةِ. Holy Prophet ﷺ, well, he was in an unconscious state on the ground, he said, oh my son, say La ilaha illallah. And he recited, raised his voice and recited at the same time, La ilaha illallah. And Holy Prophet ﷺ said, my companions, look at him. He is a person who will definitely go to Jannah. This spiritual state and this state of ecstasy which he received in the company of Holy Prophet ﷺ became an evidence of being his Ahlul Jannah. Then the companions asked, فَقَالَ أَصْحَابُهُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَمِنْ بَيْنَنَا. He is still in us. He is not dead. He is still with us. And you are guaranteeing him for Jannah. Holy Prophet ﷺ said, قَالَ مَا سَمِئْتُمْ قَوْلَهُ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ خَافَ مَقَامِ وَخَافَ وَعِيدِ. This Jannah has been promised by Almighty Allah for those who fear in standing in front of me. And he had this God-fearing and he achieved the state of ecstasy in the fear of Almighty Allah and in love of Almighty Allah, and he fell down and became unconscious. So this spiritual state of heart will definitely take him to the Jannah. This is reported by Imam Ibn Qudama on authority of great Imams of Hadith. Another narration related by Imam Ibn Qudama on authority of Imam Muhammad bin Hashim. He says, لَمَّا نَزَلَتْ هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةِ, that some people and some stones would be put in hell, and through the stones hell fire will burn. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited this verse of Quran, and Imam Ibn Qudama relates, فَسَمِعَهَا شَابٌ إِلَىٰ جَنْبِهِ. There was a young companion. I am relating all these hadiths related to the young companions of Holy Prophet. Youngsters, the youth of that time. The youth of the time of Holy Prophet amongst the companions. So you have to receive some lesson from the youth of Holy Prophet's time. A young person was sitting next to Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he heard, all of a sudden he fell down, he raised his voice and he fell down, and Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam became unconscious. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam put his head in his lap. فَجَعَلَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ رَأْسَهُ فِي حَجْرِهِ رَحْمَةً لَهُ فَمَاكَسَ مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَمْكَسَ. And he put his head in his lap for long time, and he slept there in Holy Prophet's lap as much as he wanted. Thumma fataha aynayhi. After quite long time, he opened his eyes. And when he opened his eyes, he found فَإِذَا رَأْسَهُ فِي حَجَرِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, that his head is in the lap of Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. When he opened his eyes, again a state of ecstasy started on him. And he said with loud voice, bi abi anta wa ummi mislu ayya shay'in al-hajar. Mislu ayya shay'in al-hajar. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that stone, what would be those stones like? What would be those stones like? What would be those stones like? These were the words on his mouth, on his tongue, and he was repeating them again and again. Holy Prophet ﷺ said, try to be, control your condition. What has happened to you, it is already enough. Then again, Imam Ibn Qudama reports, on authority of Imam Hassan al-Basri radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and the same narration has been related on authority of Imam Anas bin Sirin also. And he relates this on authority of Huzaifa radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the great companion of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says, Kana shabun ala ahdi Rasulillah sallallahu alaihi wasallam yabki inda zikrin nar. There was a youngster in the days of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Medina Tayyiba. Whenever he heard mentioning of dozakh, mentioning of jahannam, mentioning of hellfire, he used to cry a lot. He used to cry. Hatta habasahu zalika fil bayt. And once he started crying, and he went on crying, and he went on crying, so much so that he shut his door and locked himself in a room just to cry. He locked himself in a room. See, these are the practices of the companions. Some people think that are these kind of conditions and practices, can these things be established and proved in the lives of the companions? Yes, all these conditions have been mentioned in the lives of companions. In the days of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he locked himself in the door, in his room. فَذُكِرَ ذَلِكَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ وَسَلَّمَ فَأَتَاهُ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ فَلَمَّا نَظَرَ إِلَيَّ الشَّابُ قَامَ فَأَعْتَنَقَهُ وَخَرَّ مَيْتًا. Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم went to his house. He asked, for the last so many days I have not seen that youngster, that young boy. Companions told him, Ya Rasulullah, he has locked himself in his house and he is going on crying and he is crying. Holy Prophet ﷺ went to his house to see him. When he entered his room and the youngster, the young boy saw him, he stood up. While he was crying, he stood up and he all of a sudden embraced Holy Prophet ﷺ. He took Holy Prophet in his arms, embraced, and when he embraced Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all of a sudden he fell down on the floor and he was dying. He was dead. The companions found him dead. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam then arranged his grave and his burial and read Salatul Janaza on him. And he put with his own hands in his grave. And Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, this was the person who asked for refuge from Almighty Allah and he gave him. Then there was another hadith reported by Imam Ibn Qudama, and this hadith has been reported by Thabit al-Bunani on authority of Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. He says, دَخَلْنَا عَلَىٰ رَجُلٍ مِّنَ الْأَنْصَارِ وَهُوَ مَرِيدٌ. The companions say, Anas ibn Malik رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ says that we went to see a person who belonged to the tribe of Ansar, to a tribe of Ansar. He was ill, he was sick. We went to see him. We were sitting there and inquiring about his health. In front of our eyes, he died. That young person, he died while we were sitting in his room. فَبَسَطْنَا لَهُ ثَوْبَهُ. So we put some cloth, a chadar, a cloth on him. And then we came out and we told to his old mother. There was an old lady, his mother, sitting there. He was quite old. We told her, أُمٌّ لَهُ عَجُوزٌ كَبِيرَةٌ إِنْ دَرَاسٍ. We told her. And somebody amongst us told him, whatever has happened to your son, be patient and contented with Almighty Allah. Do sabr. Have patience and contentment on Almighty Allah. She understood what we were saying. She said, Amata ibni? Has my son died? What are you telling me? What are you talking about? Has my son died? We said, Naam, yes. Then he asked, Qalat, Ahakkun ma taqulun? Is it right? Has he really died? He was an old lady, companion of Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and she had embraced Islam few years before. She left Makkah and the Kuffar and her family, came to Medina, saw Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, embraced Islam. Soon after her embracement, her young son died. They said, yes, we are telling you the truth. فَمَدَّتْ يَدَهَا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ فَقَالَتْ اللَّهُمَّ تَعْلَمُ إِنِّي أَسْلَمْتُ وَهَاجَرْتُ إِلَىٰ رَسُولِكَ. Oh Allah, she said, Oh Allah, you know that I embraced Islam and I migrated to your beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She raised her hands and said, Oh Allah, you know that I embraced Islam and migrated to your beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And at that time, I asked you that I am coming to your beloved Prophet and embracing your deen of Islam. Please help me in every time of difficulty. So now there would be no more difficult time on me in my life than this day. Help me now and don't leave me alone. This is the only son which I have, and if he dies, then there is nobody to help me. And he had already died. When she said this thing, this comes in a hadith, and Allama Ibn al-Jawzi has also quoted this thing. And Imam Ibn Qudama has reported on the authority of Anas Ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And Allama Ibn Taymiyyah quotes in his book on Karamat, and many other scholars have quoted this thing. They said, وَكَاشَفَتْ أَصَّوْبُ عَنْ وَجْهِهِ. She removed the cloth from his face and he said, we were still sitting there. وَكَاشَفَتْ أَصَّوْبُ عَنْ وَجْهِهِ. His young son who had died, he removed the cloth of his face, he got up and said, I am alive. فَمَا بَرِهْنَا حَتَّى تَعِمْنَا مِنُّ. Then he sat with us and he had lunch and dinner with us, and after that we went back. After death, with dua of that old lady in the name of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was again, Almighty Allah turned him back to life. Then a beautiful tradition.